In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear friends, today the Church keeps the memorial of Saint Bonaventure, whose name means good venture, or good efforts, or good works. Bonaventure was a contemporary of Saint Thomas Aquinas, and he was his intimate friend. He joined the Franciscan order, and there he became also the general of his order. He brought about various reformation in the order. In 1265, when Pope Clement IV nominated Bonaventure as Archbishop of York, he resolutely declined the offer. Later on, his successor Gregory X selected Pope as the Cardinal. And when the Pope's emissaries came to his monastery near Florence, they found him washing dishes and were told to hang the Cardinal's hat on a nearby tree until he had finished it. This was his humility. And at the behest of the Pope, this cardinal arranged the council at Lyons, and he moderated the deliberations. Saint Bonaventure always attached the utmost importance to preaching and seized every opportunity, whether to the lay people or priests or before Pope, he expounded the wealth and novelty of the Word of God. In today's first reading, we see the Lord asking Moses' help to liberate his people. The Lord could have directly dealt it in a manner which Pharaoh would not expect. But however, the Lord chose the way through mediate his redemption through Moses. And that's how we see the Lord says that I will be with you, and through the miracles that we work, the heart of Pharaoh will allow my people to come for worship. Today, the Lord needs our hands, our feet, our eyes for his mission. Do I use it for his mission or my own selfish vested interests? Let us examine and see. In today's gospel, we come across one of the most consoling verses of the New Testament, uniquely found in the Gospel of Mark alone. The invitation of Jesus, the offer of Jesus for rest and consolation, peace and solace. Come to me all who are heavily burdened. I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I'm gentle and humble of heart. Jesus was known as the best carpenter in Nazareth. And he was used to make the best of the yoke. And yoke in those days were not like our days, which was ready-made, like X, double XL, or medium or large. Every measurement, every inch of the ox measurement, neck of the ox measurement was taken by individual carpenters so as to make the yoke perfect fitting for the ox so that it may not injure the neck of the ox. And that's how Jesus became the best of carpenter. And therefore he uses the same imagery of his trade and says, take my yoke upon you and learn from me. The yoke that Jesus gives to each one of us is the yoke of love. Love of God and love of neighbor. And love can never be burdensome. Love is the only sane act. Love is the only act that which gives meaning, purpose, vision and vocation for our lives. Therefore, as we gaze upon the selfless love of Jesus on the cross, for our redemption and the redemption of the world, may we be drawn to his wavelength of love and mercy so that as we surrender our hearts and homes to him, we pray for the grace that every day of our lives, in our decision, in our choices, in our thinking, in our attitude, in our actions, we may follow Jesus, meek and humble of heart. Like the woman at the well, I was seeking for things that could not satisfy. But then I heard my Savior speaking, drawn from the well that never shall run dry. Fill my cup, Lord, I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Soul, bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up and make it whole. There are millions in this world who are craving the pleasure earthly things afford. But none can match the wondrous treasure that I find in Jesus Christ my Lord. Fill my cup, Lord, and I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up, make me whole. Jesus, you invite us to experience the solace and comfort of your most sacred heart, burning with love and compassion to each one of us when we encounter failure, rejection, ingratitude in our life here on earth. May we always find the way to your most sacred heart, and there we may experience the comfort and solace that you offer to us in loving you and loving our neighbor. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God bless us, may protect us from all evil, and lead us to life everlasting. Amen.